Hello and welcome to Atomic How To. I'm Glenn, and in this video I'll show you the first of two approaches you can use to deal with doubly charged ion interferences. I'll start with triple quadrupole ICP-MS, and part three will focus on single quad ICP-MS. Now, this video is the second part in a three-part series. In part one, I explained what doubly charged interferences are, and you can see that video by clicking on the link below or searching Agilent ICP-MS, what are doubly charged interferences? By the way, if you found this video when you were looking for information on dealing with polyatomic ion interferences or the helium collision mode, click the link below or search for helium collision mode video in your preferred search engine or in YouTube. But first, let's have a quick recap of the problem itself. We'll use an example of measuring trace levels of arsenic in the presence of neodymium or samarium. Now, both neodymium and samarium have an isotope at mass 150. If the neodymium and samarium atoms lose two electrons in the plasma, they'll form ions with a 2+ charge. Quadrupole separates ions by their mass to charge ratio, so a doubly charged ion appears at half of its true mass, that is mass 75, the same mass as arsenic. This is a problem, because the signal from the doubly charged neodymium and samarium will contribute to the signal we measure for arsenic at mass 75, giving us an overestimation of the arsenic concentration. So let's take a look how we can rid ourselves of these pesky doubly charged interferences. Without any question, the best way to deal with doubly charged ion overlaps is to use a triple quadrupole or tandem ICP-MS, known as ICP-MSMS or ICP-QQQ. This instrument allows us to use a reactive gas to chemically resolve the overlaps. You can learn more about this technique by entering the search term chemical resolution in ICP-QQQ. ICP triple quad resolves the doubly charged ion overlaps on arsenic using oxygen cell gas to form arsenic oxide product ions in the cell. The beauty of this method is that it moves arsenic away from both the doubly charged ions and any polyatomic ion interferences such as argon chloride and calcium chloride. It's really that simple. The method only works with MSMS though, because we need the extra mass filter before the cell to remove any other ions that could overlap with the arsenic product ions, such as zirconium at mass 91. And MSMS will also remove any other ions that might react with the oxygen cell gas to form a product ion at mass 91. So for example, germanium 74 plus oxygen 17 would overlap arsenic oxide at mass 91 if we didn't use MSMS. Oxygen reaction mode is great with a triple quad, but if you don't have an instrument of this type, reactive cell gases will more likely cause more problems than they solve, especially if your samples contain a lot of other elements. You can find out more information about correcting for doubly charged ion overlaps on agilent.com, including any application notes on this and many other ICP-MS solutions. Check out part 3 to learn about dealing with doubly charged interferences in single quadrupole ICP-MS. And finally, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.